What would you say if I told you that I've just done an experiment where our original version delivered a 10% conversion rate and our new version brought in 20%? Most people would say, oh my god, you doubled the conversion rate. But someone who A/B tests like a data scientist would ask for more information. Show me the math. What were the absolute values? In version A we had 10 users and 1 conversion, and in version B we had another 10 users and 2 conversions. Everybody can tell that the 100% conversion increase, in this case, is rather a result of chance and natural variance than something real. In other words, this result is not statistically significant. What if we have 10,000 users in version A and 10,000 users in version B and 1,000 conversions here and 2,000 conversions there? Of course, in this case, there is no doubt that the result is real and that it's statistically significant. We have too many data points to assume any role of chance or natural variance here. Well, these were two intuitive examples, but quite often in A/B testing, our results are not that intuitive. For instance, what would you say when you have 1,000 users each for A and B, and for version A the number of conversions is 37, for version B it's 49? Is the difference real, or is this just another trick of natural variance, chance, and randomness? You have already heard me mention the expression statistical significance. This mathematical concept is implemented to help you decide in unclear situations like this one. There are different ways to calculate statistical significance, and I will get back to that soon, but first, let me just show you the result. After running the numbers, the statistical significance of this A/B test result is around 91%. What does it mean? Well, if I want to put it simply, there is a 91% probability that these results are real, and a 9% probability that they are due to chance. Let me rephrase it so you can see the business aspect too. There's a 91% chance that you will get similar results after you shut down the test and publish your winning version, and there is a 9% chance that you will get worse results, in some cases worse than your original version was. In the next videos, I will talk about whether 91% statistical significance is enough or not. But first, let me show you one more thing here. How can you calculate statistical significance for yourself? Well, first of all, usually you don't have to. Most of the tools do this for you as well. For instance, Optimizely, one of my favorite A/B testing tools, continuously recalculates and reports the level of significance of your running experiments. So when you see, say, 11%, you know that you will still have to run your test for a while. The other thing I like in Optimizely statistics engine is that they also give you an estimate about how many more users you need to get conclusive results. Well, in this example, it's a lot. By the way, we have similar features in Google Optimize and in most A/B testing tools. If for some reason the tool you use doesn't do the calculations for you automatically, you can still take advantage of one of the many online statistical significance calculators out there. I will add a few of these in the extra lecture, but they pretty much work the same way. So here is just one simple example from VWO's calculator. I type my numbers, click calculate, and boom, I got my results. The p-value shows the probability that my results are due to chance, which is around 9% in this case, and that means that our statistical significance is 100% minus 9%, which is 91%. Not that hard, but very useful. Before I finish this video, let me mention that I simplified and generalized a few things here. I balanced between being practical but comprehensible. From a purely business perspective, the things you have heard here will be just perfect for you to calculate your significance rate. But if you love statistics and you want to go deeper into the exact mathematical calculations and understand, for instance, what's behind VWO's significance calculator, go to the extra section of this module. There I will add a few more thoughts, articles that I wrote or that other data scientists wrote that go much deeper into statistics.